This is the Mojave Air and Spaceport, a scrap of desert outside Los Angeles. It's where Richard Branson's Virgin Galactic has set up shop to test its tourist space planes.
But today we're gonna get a tour of another vehicle. It's a Boeing 747 that's been turned into a mobile launch pad in order to send rockets to orbit mid-flight.
We're here to meet Kelly Latimer, the main pilot for Virgin Orbit. It's a sibling company of Virgin Galactic that hopes to launch satellites into space instead of tourists. But they want to do it in a way that sets them apart from most of the satellite launching competition out there. Instead of launching rockets from the ground, Virgin Orbit launches them from under the wing of a giant airplane. Or they will if a whole lot of tests go right first.
This is Launcher One, the rocket that Virgin Orbit has developed. It's designed to fly mounted underneath the wing of the 747. And then at around 35,000 feet, the pilot flips a few switches and this big red clamp releases the rocket. It falls away and then it ignites its engine to climb into space.
This way of getting to space is often referred to as air launch. It's not a new concept either. Both Northrop Grumman and a company called Stratolaunch use similar systems. Air launch is also the same basic way Virgin Galactic gets its space plane into the sky too. Still, this type of space travel is pretty rare, but it's got its upsides.
There is just a raw performance advantage that we get.
This is Will Pomerantz, Vice President of Special Projects at Virgin Orbit and the company's first employee.
If you think about two rockets racing their way to space, one starting at Cape Canaveral and one starting under the wing of an airplane, well, the one at Cape Canaveral, which is a great facility, but it happens to be at 0 feet above sea level and 0 miles per hour, and our airplane is already giving us some altitude and some speed.
There's also some flexibility you get when your launch pad can move.
So if there's bad weather in one location, we can go somewhere else. If we've got five different customers that want to go to five different orbits, physics is going to dictate we want to launch them from five different places. And instead of having to build five different launch sites, we just pick up our whole launch system and we fly it anywhere it wants to go. You know, it's a Boeing 747. It's about as transportable as you can possibly make it.
The 747 that Virgin Orbit uses is an old passenger aircraft from Virgin Atlantic, aptly nicknamed Cosmic Girl. But the plane looks a tad different these days. The entire coach section has been completely gutted, all of its seats removed, and the overhead bins taken out.
Yeah, we basically pulled the entire main deck interior out to get rid of weight. So we got rid of about 50,000 pounds. So what it gives us is the lighter weight, the better performance we get.
The first class cabin is also no longer outfitted for rich travelers. Instead, the upstairs has been transformed into a small mission control so that engineers can oversee missions during flight. Kelly's job mostly revolves around flying the plane, and she's got a lot of experience with that already. As a lieutenant colonel in the Air Force, she flew numerous military aircraft, and she's got experience with 747s too, having flown the airplane that carried the space shuttle, as well as a flying observatory called Sophia. This mission may start off like a regular 747 flight, but it ends much differently.
Once the rocket gets fully fueled, we'll come on board the aircraft, start the engines, taxi out to the end of the runway, and take off just like a conventional airplane. If anything were to go wrong, we want to be able to jettison it at any point, so we have a specific routing to get us out over the water.
Then when it comes time to drop the rocket, Kelly maneuvers the plane, pitching it up at a 30-degree angle. That orients the rocket towards space. And if everything's at the right altitude and speed, the rocket drops.
So at that point, the rocket's on its own. We pull off to the right, and meanwhile, the rocket counts to five and then lights its motor and goes off to space.
So basically, you ditch it and run.
Pretty much, yeah.
Kelly does have to make a few accommodations flying a plane with a rocket attached. When the rocket is fully fueled, it'll add an extra 50,000 pounds, putting more weight on the left side of the plane. That means they'll have to add more fuel to the right wing to offset the imbalance. But up until now, Kelly's been flying Launcher One without any fuel in it, making the vehicle something of a ghost.
So what does it feel like for you whenever you're flying, knowing that you have essentially a rocket or a missile attached to your plane?
What's funny is when we flew the first time with the rocket attached, there actually was so little effect for the rocket being there that we were like, you know, if we didn't have this panel in front of us and somebody telling us that there was a rocket on board, I'm not sure we would actually know.
The Launcher One rocket is only designed to put small payloads into orbit, those about the size of a washing machine. Virgin Orbit is capitalizing on the trend towards smaller and smaller satellites, thanks to cheaper consumer electronics and the standardization of satellite hardware. It puts them in competition with launch providers like Rocket Lab, Vector, Relativity, and more than 100 other startups focused on sending small satellites to space. Virgin Orbit is still deep in the midst of its testing program. Farther out into the desert, it's testing its small rocket engine at this firing range. And there's a lot of complexity that comes from lighting the engine up in midair.
When you're launching things from the ground, you know, if you need power for your system, you go and you plug it into an electrical outlet. And if you need fuel, you plug it into a pipeline. When you're launching from an airplane, you've got to build all that stuff so that A, it physically fits on board the airplane, and then B, it's safe and it's regulatorily appropriate to carry it on board an airplane.
So while Virgin Orbit is testing its engines, it's also testing Cosmic Girl. The company routinely runs test flights, and recently, they've been flying with Launcher One attached. Soon, the company will fill up the rocket with water to give it a more realistic weight, and they'll drop it just to see if it falls like the engineers think it will. When that test happens, Kelly will be testing out how to deploy Launcher One for the first time too, switching on a series of buttons and levers that cause Launcher One to fall from the wing.
So we basically set it up to drop, you go left to right, and then once we're done, we go close hook, back to lock, and you go right.
Of course, there's always the possibility that rockets don't behave like we think they will. And Kelly is prepared for that too.
Do you have contingency plans in case that dropping doesn't go well, or heaven forbid, you know, it ignites when you're still carrying it?
Yep, we do, and that's the reason for having the control set up here and really not have it tied to a lot of computer logic or data. So at any point, we can let it go. So we basically will have some what we call go-no-go parameters or abort or knock it off criteria. Things start to go out of limits to where it's trending in a bad way. At any point in our flight, we simply unlock, arm, and then release.
Virgin Orbit is aiming to do its first test launch in 2019, but there's still a lot of testing to do first, including that crucial drop test. But once that happens, Kelly is excited for what comes next.
That's when the buildup to the actual launch is gonna get really exciting, really fun. We'll find all sorts of stuff we'll work through, you know, and make our way through it. But yeah, the actual takeoff, knowing that we're gonna drop the rocket for launch, is gonna be very thrilling.
One last small question.
Yep.
Do you have an idea of what the first payload will be when this all...
Yeah, that's a secret. Yeah.
Fine.
No information. I know nothing. Yeah. Actually, the payload, I don't even care. I'm just going to drop it off. I'm just the bus driver. I just take it to its bus stop and let it go.
I love it.